It is a combination fascination and destination. The Science Museum is a standalone. It is where people come to be curious and to be informed.
This is a Minnesota iconic institution here in St. Paul. It's over 110 years old, been in St. Paul in a few different locations. This is actually our third location here along the Mississippi River Bluffs, and it's an amazing place that welcomes thousands of visitors every weekend, every day. We have school groups that come in, nearly 200,000 school groups each year.
The idea is to captivate, particularly school-age children. What that means is you have to be relevant, but more importantly, you have to grab a person's attention so they understand science is more than a microscope or a study of an equation. It's about entertaining someone.
We make science fun by making it, I said hands-on, right? So we make it a sort of an experience that you today are going to, you know, learn about physics by actually jumping up in the air and doing a vertical jump. You know, it's taking that science concept and actually either making it through a hands-on activity where maybe you're pulling a lever on a machine.
So many of the exhibits have captured the imagination and in so doing met the needs. One of the big hits, the recreation of the dinosaur, and the realization that these oversized man-eating creatures actually roamed on our same soil.
It's really thinking about the visitor. What would be fun and engaging? What brings to light the latest science topic, or even maybe not even latest discovery, but maybe some historical discovery? So we have the largest dinosaur and fossil collection here in Minnesota.
The biggest blockbuster was a look inside us, literally, allowing people to look at the body and figure out its function, and that by itself became a fascination.
Body Rolls was probably the biggest and most memorable science exhibit that the museum has had in recent history. It welcomed nearly a million visitors through its doors. And what was really crazy for us is we were open 24 hours the last couple weekends before it closed because people had to see it before it left. It was really, truly unique. It was one of the first times people outside of the medical world were able to see the human body as doctors do and see what's under our skin.
That brings us to another function of the body. Most have tried to figure out the performance of sports. We ask ourselves, why can some do the incredible when someone that seems to have the same physical features not achieve the same heights? Fair questions that have haunted many of us since Little League. Welcome to Sportsology. That's right, they are now demonstrating some of the measurables, as in, do you really know what your reaction time is relative to the rest of the world?
As we age, sometimes our reaction time gets a little bit slower, but also as an athlete, you can improve your reaction time too.
So if you're aging and you're an athlete, you're still pretty good, probably like me. So
yeah,
I just hit the button here.
Yes,
and
see?
So I hit the button and then I wait here, and how quickly I can grab it when it falls tells me my reaction time.
How fast your reaction is. So
let's
see how it goes. All right.
I think that was in the excellent category.
This is an area you can find out more about yourself and how you compare to, say, an NFL wide receiver.
Maybe Eric Halla, got Kristen Press, Adam Thielen, Candace Wiggins, and our old favorite TC Bear.
I'm going to pick Adam Thielen because I know Adam well and I know that he can't stay with me in the short distance.
Here comes Adam. I got you, buddy. I own you today.
3, 2, 1, go!
Almost hit him.
Great race.
I don't know if you can see it, but I had him and I tweaked a hammy a little bit. Otherwise, I would beat him easy going away.
It's an adventure that has national appeal.
We saw how popular that was. It's popular to this day. It's one of their most visited exhibits. And we said, we have to bring this here for Minnesotans. They're going to love it. We're a sports-minded community and active cities. And so we just knew it would be a big hit, and it has been.
So you can test your hand-eye on a moving target.
So this tests your hand-eye coordination almost for any sport that uses a ball, whether it's football, basketball, baseball, tennis, whatever.
Absolutely. So if you think about how many sports there are, archery, football, baseball, they all need hand-eye coordination. Mm-hmm. And those of us who even aren't athletes, it's pretty good to keep those skills developed later in life, right?
For sure. Now,
yeah.
I was an all-conference quarterback and outfielder, so this is child's play for me. But for some people, they may struggle a bit.
That's the idea of this. To allow interaction and engagement, and to allow peer entertainment. That's where the Omni Theater comes in at the Science Museum, a staple that allows a movie experience like you have not experienced it, a participation like no other.
The Omni Theater is an incredible treasure to the Science Museum. It is one of a kind. It is a 90-foot domed screen. It's one of two domed theaters in the world. And it's truly incredible because you are seeing a movie like you can't see anywhere else.
It's a piece of cake.
I'll just stick to what I do, like comparing my basketball form to that of Lindsay Whalen's.
One, go.
How pretty is that?
Great job.
Even he said great job. Plus, I can do this when I'm done doing it. How many people can do that?
Life to the Max is brought to you by LifeTouch, photography for a lifetime.